All right, welcome back. We move on with the class today. We are aware of our back end. Now, this is the back end. This is the front end. This is the payment template. Anytime you purchase a payment template, there's always a documentation to guide you through. As you can see this one, thank you for purchasing my team. If you have any questions like that are beyond the scope of this file, feel free to email Fair My User. You can click this contact to know where it is. You can see the email here. You can see the production date and some other things. In case you have anything, that's one of the rights you have. If you purchase the template, you'll be able to communicate with the builder direct, and they will be willing to solve the question for you. But if you didn't buy the template, maybe you extract it from some other source, free template, you might not have any support for the template. You have to. About that.
Sorry, how did you get to this very place?
To this place. This is documentation. So when you purchase, this is the file. Okay?
Okay.
This is the main template. Then documentation. From documentation here, you see the documentation to show you how you can work with this mindset and some other things.
Go back to that
documentation.
Yes.
You open this.
So this index now.
That
I
is
can
where
open
you
it
have
my HTML.
Your browser, yes.
And I can work on it.
You can't work on it. You can't work on it. You can't work on it. It's just a documentation for you.
Right.
You know, guys, thank you. All right. So here now, let's see what we are going to do first. This documentation. I won't really bother much to read about this. So, but it's very important that you read the instructions. Me, I'm aware. Like this, how to install that theme, which I've done. Like you need to extract it, navigate appearance, which we did the other time. So that's on the installation. Then how to do your menu. I've been doing that.
The pages,
the posts. So you now have what we call the widgets. Widget is another very important. Widget depicts how your the structure of a website. Can you see Twitter widget, Facebook widget, and so on. Different widgets. Can you see tab widgets? Facebook like. So let's see how the widgets work.
Now, so if you want to do the widgets, you come into appearance.
Okay.
Widgets.
So that is actually the structure of a website. You can see on the sidebar. You know what your sidebar name?
This is your sidebar here,
right?
So on the sidebar,
can you see what do you want there? If you want the Facebook fan like page. Can you see? You click, you hold it, then you drag it. Right?
Okay.
Then where's our Twitter?
You want the Twitter to follow? So let me drop this one. Right?
So on, you can see this widget is on Twitter. Available widgets. Those are the active. Inavailable. So anyone that you don't want, you can drag it and put it there to make it inactive. So here now, on this Facebook first, here, what you need to do is to type your Facebook URL there. Right? So in my own case now, http://www.facebook.com. Okay? facebook.com/SIT Center. Right?
That's the page where you can like.
Yes. SIT Center. You put the page, your Facebook fan book, put it there. Or your Facebook ID. If you want it to be showing the face of people on your Facebook, as you can see this documentation. Right, you specify it. Right, so you specify the face. For more information, you can check www.lydyoruba.com. See some stuff like that. Can you see if you want it as people are posting message to be showing the screen? Right, if you want it to show the Facebook header.
What
the title of the Facebook? Those are just like, can you see instead of this now, show the Facebook on the title. So you can customize it the way you want. When you are done, save it. You can also resize. As you save it like this, you can dock it. So if you want to try again, right? You also put your Twitter ID, right? Just the ID, not twitter.com/. Yes. So you can just write at SIT Center. If this doesn't work, just put your normal ID, right? You save. You call up. Then you want the visitors counter, right? Facebook counter to tell you how many people that like your thing on Facebook. This can actually be up. It depends on how you want to do your arrangement, right? So, your Facebook follower, right? You save it as well. So, if we are online right now, this will appear somewhere here. Can you see Facebook feed? Right? We're showing the counter because we are not young. We'll collect this system to online along the line to see how this preview, right? So, this is Facebook. This is your Twitter streaming will be here. You understand? We are building. I told you widget is all about the structure. Right? Then, apart from that, again, still on widget. So, there are so many things here. You can see the tab, the latest review, how you want it to be on your footer. Footer is the bottom of the page. This is footer. Let me see if the footer is here. Right? This is the way your tweet. Can you see your tweet? Your recent post. That's the latest review. Right? So you can arrange your stuff the way you want. So if I want the Twitter here now, I want the recent posts. Right? I can put it here. Recent post on the social media. Also put if you want the calendar, this is optional. Tab that will show the popular posts, the most comments, and all your tags. Do you understand? You can also put it the archive of all the posts so that if anybody wants to check the last 1 year post, right? So you have the archive here, right? So you can your user can browse it, right? Can browse through. You want it to be dropped down, you just want it to be showing the counts, how many. So you customize it the way you want. So let's check the preview of this. As I told you earlier, widget is structure. So the way you structure it, that's the way your page will be. This is basically at the bottom. Can you see? Right? Recent post. You can decide to put it on the sidebar. This one we might not put it here. Definitely, I won't put it here if you have to do something like this. To show the popular post, there's nothing. The comments, like this is default comment, the tag post, and so on. So, this one is not actually good yet. So, let's see where I will restructure that one to now. What do I call it? Not this one. Where is it? Okay, the first one. So, I'm moving this now. Recent post. Can you see what I'm doing now? I want to place it to join the sidebar, right? So it should look more mature there, right? So your arrangement is very, very important. It right, I can just put other things there. So, I also move this now. Your sidebar is very, very important and it makes your stuff look more organized. Tab, this one will go most read comments and so on. Right, this is much more arranged. Yeah, so archive can be here. Calendar can be also be here. Let's put calendar there. Can dock this up. Right. Where's calendar? Right. Here it is. Do different stops then from here now if you want to customize like all this, can you see this is all your name? You want to put the company you are developing for, all the stuff you want to put everything there. All you have to do still not on your widget this time around. This is the name of the team. So you click on the name of the team, then you do some other necessary thing. So like your logo now, here now, you can just browse your logo. Right? The you have any logo here?
Wallpaper. Anyway, let me just use anything to do example.
I thought I have some of my stuff here. So you don't have anything? My stuff?
Yes.
My logo?
Go to class.
Class. On your desktop?
Yes.
Alright. Okay. I show my logo here. Right? Yeah, just send me our picture.
Go back again. Where did you go now?
Class.
Countries. Go back.
Alright. The stuff that I gave you, where did you go? Anyway, that's by the way. So I can use anything to represent that. I don't care for now. So this one just represents the logo. So can you see the directory? Then
favicon.
I think you understand what favicon means by now.
Yes.
Yes. So definitely your logo. You browse it and make use of it as a favicon, right? If you have feed, then anything you do, one thing, make sure you save it, right? And it will tell you that option saved. If you refresh now, you will see that. Okay, can you see it's too big? So if I want to do the logo, I'll make sure that it's the size. Can you see what is it on a favicon? Right? So what I will do presently now is that because that is not my logo. So you need to know the
size
of your logo. Right? So the size of that logo is actually this. Right? 178. By 53. Okay. Before we go into that, on your home setting, this is where you set your slide bar. Let me show you something here. If it is here, your slider. Is it here? I'll show you how to get that. Let's go back to this. Where is the USC?
Photoshop now.
It's open with the logo size. Right? If you want to edit it, well, if you don't want to edit it, once you know the size, 174 by 83 or 85. So you do that for your logo. So can you see the logo? And as you can see, it's likely to be PNG also. Right? So this is logo, and we want you to do your own, right?
Size. This one is even 170 by 50. Right?
So you can do your own logo. Let me quickly do something small.
174 by 85. Then, so I can remove the background later.
So look at this. This is your Photoshop. You have something like this. Okay. You don't want this color. Or something like this. Then give it bold. Then have something like this. This font is too big. S. Just follow up. Yeah. solid italic.
Solid.
Allo solid italic. Yes. Then. Control T. Allo solid italic. Can you see? This is on small letter or capital letter. Italic. Alright. Yes. Looking at how to turn this to yes, small letter. Can I see all caps? Look at this, all caps. That will give you that. I'm just trying to show you how I got our software. Just trying to show you. When somebody called me, like, oh, I don't see that font, I can easily say, check Allo Solid Italic capital letter. That's one of the stuff for logo. It should be something that anybody can play with. You don't need to be designing. So that's stuff like this. So so you can have something like this. This font is too big. Yeah. You just want to do this for logo. I'm reducing this icon to see man less than. So right. Control shift after you align greater than you increase the size. So then
if I may ask, are you the one that designed the software?
Yes. One thing when you are designing logo, always have it in mind that you want something that somebody will not be looking at. Where do you cough? Where do you do this thing? Draw a shape, put this particular font, you are there. There is a logo that used to impress me all the time. That even though with Microsoft Word you can come up with this, and logo should be something that anybody can play with. MTA is even hard. GT Bank. Just draw a cube, then I see back. Very simple. And that is exactly the way logo should be. That is exactly the way logo should be. It's not to be something that people will now be taking jam before they can get your stuff. Right? So that is the reason why you have to do this. So, software, this is actually the logo, but not this. So, if I want to use this one now, right? This has our background logo for that stuff. Look at the layer here. For those of you that don't know color Photoshop, you need to go and learn some stuff. You tell some people that you just get this from Photoshop and they're like, ow. So you can remove the background. I just did that. Right? So to make your PNG look better. Like so. Let me quickly save this for PNG. Then no, I've not removed the background. Right. File, save PNG. Save. I just put it on the desktop. Do you have any logo there? I want to bring this now as our logo. You should make sure that your logo is ready. This my logo is out maybe because we stay long a little bit.
Yeah.
General. I can see the logo here now. Yeah. Logo. Upload. Let's check it. So that's how you have to do work with the size. You can also expand the size. Just bust into the HTML and CSS code. Change the sizes to how you want it. Then you do it. Can you see the way it looks like? So that's how to do this. In the next class, we're going to see how to prepare our slide here, the scrolling, and some other things about this website. You should have it in mind that most of the WordPress team comes with different challenges, but you get to learn much more. Thank you for listening.
Sorry, sir, because this place that is showing is because we are inside the.
Yes, because we log in as admin.